Man, FMG Capo, man, Capo Vision TV. Before I get this video started, y'all go subscribe to the channel, press that like button, comment on what's going on, man. Topic, man. The homie that almost got beat up, you know what I'm saying, by an ex-member, man, ex-gang member. The guy that I'm talking about that he got into it with, you know, he was an ex-gangster disciple in prison. So basically what that mean in prison, it ain't like Cripple Blood. Usually Cripple Blood, they gonna smash you. They gonna beat you down, beat you on up off the set. Basically, and don't get me wrong, sometimes GDs beat dudes up off, you know what I'm saying, and send them on to the back. But this time, they basically call it off count. Like if they really mess with you, you just did something bogus, they're going to put you off count and they still going to let you live on the compound. So that's what's going on with this cat that the homie done got into it with. So one of the little homies, he from around the area. He a real funny dude. He always laughing, joking, playing and stuff like that. But he love to hoop. He love to play on that court. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of times when affiliations play on the court, you always got other people out there for, like, security. So, you know what I'm saying? If the Crips, a lot of Crips hooping, you're going to have the Crips on the sideline just in case something crack off. Because that's where a lot of problems start at on the basketball court. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if a lot of civilians know that, but in prison, the basketball court is dangerous. A war could pop off over the basketball court. So, you know, me and the homie, we used to go out there. Cuz used to play the ex-gangster disciple dude one-on-one all the time. And the ex-gangster disciple dude, I'm not going to lie, like, he was always just trying to be super tough. I don't know if he was trying to prove himself to the GD so he could get back on count, but he always just walked around like he was tough. He was really slick cruising for a bruise. But at the end of the day, I ain't going to lie, you know what I'm saying? Like, he wasn't no sucker. And he was a nice-sized dude. He worked out every day. You know what I'm saying? Like, you could tell he ain't just going to be no pushover. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know what him and the homie had going on. I don't know if they was gambling on basketball. I don't know if one day one another then challenged each other, but they just started playing basketball a lot. But when they was on the basketball court, they was always arguing, was always getting tough, pushing each other, like it was gonna end up being a problem. So, and don't get me wrong, the little homie, he was like a little short, little fat dude. You know what I'm saying? He ain't really work out too much. About the most working out he gonna do is playing basketball, even though that's good cardio, but he ain't really just strong and little short, little fat, little stubby little homie. So, you know, they had been on the court. Me and the homies would be out there. They arguing, pushing each other, always getting into it, talking about each other, cheating, things of that nature out there. But, you know, me and the homie, we was talking about it. We was like, man, one day they going to get to fighting or something out here. But I'm not going to lie, the little homie, the little chubby homie, he wasn't backing down. He was at him just like dude was at him. You know what I'm saying? So they, you know what I'm saying, going back and forth on the court. They've been playing it this time probably about 4 or 5 days. So, boom, they finally get into it. We trying to calm the commotion down, but they got it on their mind. You know what I'm saying? They said they was going to catch their fade. So, boom, we end up going back to the pod that day. Like, what's up? What's going on? They done squashed it. So we think, you know, after they done squashed the little situation, it's done. They finna quit playing basketball because it done got too heated. Nah, bro, the next day, they right back out there. Same thing. This time, it didn't come to a head. Now, mind you, the little short, little stubby homie, he act like he just gonna beat dude up. You know what I'm saying? The prior days and stuff. Like, he talking like, man, dude ain't talking about nothing, man. A nigga smash him like he ain't nothing. You feel me? But I'm thinking in my head, like, shoot, this ain't no little dude. You just talking like dude just ain't nobody. Like, he used to be Gangster Disciple at one time. And obviously, he got some type of respect if they left him on the compound. So I'm just tripping off my head like, man, I don't know what could thinking like, dude just gonna be a real sucker or something. But you know what I'm saying? This day they done got into it again. The next day, just like I said, it done came to a head. Now it's fight time. You see what I'm saying? So me and the other homie, we just happened to be out there while all of it was going on. So boom. They like at the count, they finna go on, get down. They finna go on, catch the fade at the count. You know what I'm saying? So boom, at the count come. Oh, we slide the chow. You know what I'm saying? Me and the other homie, we talking to cuz. We like, what's up, cuz? You show? You finna go on duty? Like, yeah, man, I'm finna go on handle it, man. Dude, ain't nothing, man. We like, sure, cuz. We gonna go on security, cuz. Make sure everything's smooth. So basically, he was really trying to act like he ain't even need us. Like, bro, like, this was just gonna be an easy win or something. You feel me? But I'm thinking in my head, I'm like, man, I done seen cuz fight before. Bro, cuz ain't really got no hands for real. Like, let's just be for real here. Like, cuz, you ain't really got no hands. And don't get me wrong, I'm glad that you got confidence in yourself because you supposed to have confidence in yourself. But, like, if we being realistic here, dude slick look like a baby animal around here, though. I ain't even really gonna cap, dude. Probably about 5'9", 5'10", but he cut up, though. He ripped. Look like he work out, like he hit the weight yard every day. So it's baffling to me. And don't get me wrong. Being buff and being on the weights and stuff, that don't mean nothing. But you can kind of tell with a kid, you know what I'm saying, just about they coordination. If they moving goofy, if they move goofy. Like, dude just seem to be coordinated and, you know what I'm saying? Like, you could tell, like, and then at the time, dude had to be about 36, 37. So you could tell he done been around the block once, twice, maybe three times. Like, how do you got in your head? Like, you just underestimating this man. So we talked to Cousin Chad. We finished talking to him. Cuz, you show you want to see dude. So he like, yeah. I'm like, all right, bitch, when we go back to the pod, we finna go on, set it up, go on, get cracking real quick. So boom, me and the other homie, we walking back to the pod. I'm telling the little homie, I'm like, hey, cuz, look, check this out. Man, if dudes start getting on cuz, man, go on in there and say cuz. You feel me? Like, man, I was already gonna do that anyway. I'm like, shit, say less, bro. Boom, we slide back to the pod. I holly, dude, what's up, bro? What's up, y'all? Finna do that? He like, yeah, I'm with that. You know what I'm saying? So, boom, I'm like, I go back and tell the homie, hey, man, dude, said he with that. He ready when you is. So, the homie like, shoot, I'm ready. You feel me? So, boom. I'm telling dude, I'm like, hey, cuz, said he ready. Come on. You know what I'm saying? Boy, he slide down there. He got on his little fade, little gear. Everybody in the penitentiary got a fade attire. Got some old raggedy shoes, raggedy little shirt that they catch their little fades in. So, boom, he come down in his little fade wear or whatever. Boom. Me and cuz were like, sure, we just going to push the door. We ain't going to close it all the way just in case. You know what I'm saying? It start getting ugly. So, boom, the little XGD dude, he fall in there. So, boom, as soon as he fall in there, cuz on him. Hit him with about 3-4 good ones. But it was like when cuz hit him with the 3-4 good ones, like, dude, just like he powered up. Well, he got to turn it up on cuz and now, bink, 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 bink. And he like, he getting cuz, trying to dodge him, dude, binking him. Bink, 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 bink. Bing, bing. So, boom, I'm just finna tell the homie. I'm looking at the homie. I'm finna tell him, hey, cuz, go on in there. Now, mind you, the homie, a big, tall cuz, one of the big, tall homies, got hands. I'm like, cuz, well, as I'm saying, he already going in there. As soon as he going there, bing, 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 start binking, dude. So, by then, cuz did recover because he already getting binked up. He done recovered, and now he done kind of got on him. You know what I'm saying? So when cuz start getting on him, the homie who fell in there, he backed off a little bit and let Cub bink him a little bit. So dude like, dang, y'all gonna jump me like that? So the homie like, Cub, what you thought you finna beat up the homie? Bink, 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 bink. So that made him bink him up a few more times, man. Saying? So they end up binking fool up. But I gotta give it to bro, like, shoot, he got hard, he ain't go nowhere. He just got binked up, took his lick. Know what I'm saying? The little GDs that used to mess with him, they came in there and talked to him. It was really no issue because he ain't GD no more. Know what I'm saying? That's just how stuff go in the penitentiary. Nah, the Philly, they ain't finna show no mercy. You finna get binked up. Know what I'm saying? But dude, you know what I'm saying? I respect it, dude. Like, because he was in there fighting with both of them. Know what I'm saying? He ain't followed up no nothing. He kept it solid, man. But that's the type of stuff that go on in prison, man. I'm saying, but that's just a lesson, bro. Don't underestimate nobody, man. I don't care if you think you could beat them up, because you never know, you know what I'm saying? Some people just look like that, man. Make sure y'all subscribe to the channel, press that like button, comment on what's going on, man. 7G.